Hello. Today we are looking at exponents and indices. Now, indices, we know that the study of powers. While we talk about exponents, we are involving powers with unknowns. For example, 2 power 3, 2 is our base, 3 is our power. But involving exponents, we can have 2 power x, where x is our exponent. Now, with our level, we shall deal with indices with the same base. So what do you mean by the same base? We can look at this under the following laws. Right? The laws set, our initial law starts with, if we have a number with a power, let's say a power n, and it's multiplying with another number, a power n, our outcome will be a power, the sum of the power. Okay? You can see now, when you have the same base, and you're multiplying, we shall just add the powers. For example, if I have 2 power 4 multiplied by 2 power 2 is the same as having 2 power 4 plus 2 giving us 2 power 6. Another law could be of division. In this case, having the same base, we shall subtract the powers. For example, 2 power 4 divided by 2 power 2 will be 2, 4 minus 2, giving us 2 power 2. Another law states, if you have a power, and another power outside the brackets is exactly the same as multiplying the powers. For example, if I have 2 power 3, and another power outside is 2, this is the same as 3 times 2 giving us 2 power 6. We also have a law stating that if you have a square root of a number, it's exactly the same as power half. Sometimes you might have a cube root of a number. This means it will be p power 1 over 3. Another law states, if you have a number, it could be a denominator with a power. The law says we can change this into a numerator, but the power will change the sign. And finally, number power 0 is equal to 1. Now, these are our 6 laws. How can we use these laws? Here is the sample questions. When you look at question number 1, we are told to simplify. P power 2 times P power 3. This, according to our law, since they are the same base, we shall just take one base and we add the powers, giving us P power 6. When the same base, giving us P power 5. Why 5? because we add 2 plus 3. If we have the same base, but dividing, that means we shall subtract the powers. And it will give us m power 2. Again, as we saw the law, same base with the power, we shall multiply them. Right? This will give us k power 8. Now here we go. If we have a number which is bigger, we can factorize it first. And we shall take it as 3 power 3, n power 3 with the cube root. How shall we remove the cube root? By changing it to power 1 over 3. How shall we open the brackets? 2 power 3 times 1 over 3, n power 3 times 1 over 3, giving us 2n. When you look at the next chapter, the numerators, they're multiplying. The numerator is subtracting. We shall obtain 3, the multiplication will turn into plus, the over, which is similar to division, will turn into minus. 3 plus 2 is 5, minus 4, we shall get 1, giving us only m. Now here we go. We have H up, we have R down. But when you look at the other side, we have R up, we have H up. Now, what is our first responsibility? To make all those with the same base on the same sides. Now, if we have these, we shall multiply with H. Now, since H was down, when you bring it up, it will have a negative power. Over. We have R power 3 down. This is up. We can bring it down. When you bring it down, the power will become minus. But remember, having a square root, our power is a half. So when it comes down, the power will be negative a half. Hence, H2 plus negative 1 over R 3 plus negative a half. This will give us H up, and down it will give us 2.5. When you look at the next question, we have 64. We can factorize 64 by 2, 32, by 2, 16, by 2, 8, by 2, 4, by 2, 2, and 2, 1. This will give us 2 power 6. So our question now will be 2 power 6, A power 4, and B power 2. The next thing we shall have is to move the square root and replace with power a half. 2 power 6, A power 4, B power 2, power a half. Then we shall have to open the brackets. 2 power 6 times a half, A power 4 times a half, B power 2 times a half, giving us 2 power 3, A power 2, and B. Those are the first part of questions that help us to simplify using indices and exponents approach. Now, what if we are supposed to solve? Since we are looking at same base, we have to ensure that our question has got the same base. Now, looking at the first problem, it has got base 2 is equal to 1. But we already looked at our law that any number power 0 is 1. Since we have base 2, we shall call it 2 power 0, since we know 2 power 0 is the same as 1. Since we know 2 power 0 is the same as 1. Now, we have same base. If we have same base and they are equal, therefore, even the powers should be equal. hence giving us that our x will be zero. When you look at the second example, we have to change this line to have base 3 so that we can have all bases the same. Therefore, we know to get 9, it is 3 squared. And this side, we have 3 power 4 divided by 3 r. Now, we know if we have same base dividing, it is the same as subtracting the powers. So, we shall take it as 3, 4 minus r should be the same as 3 power 2. Bases being equal, that means even the powers should be equal. Shall take r on that side and shall bring 2 this side, giving us 4 minus 2 is r. Hence, our r is 2. Finally, we have 4 as our base, but we can change it to 2 power 2 so that we can have same base. And 1, we can change it to 2 power 0 so that we have same base, and we know any number power 0 is the same as 1, according to the indices law. Now, 2 power 2 is below. We have to take it up so that all are on the same level. By taking it up, it will change the power sign. And it will be as you can see. Now, 2 base 2, then multiplying, we shall add the powers. This will be equal to 2 power 0. And if the bases are the same, that means even the powers should be the same. If we take 2 this side, it will give us x will be 2, hence our x will be 2. This was our first part of explaining our chapter, indices and exponents. We looked at the laws. After looking at the laws, we have seen a few examples of the questions. If you enjoyed the discussion, you can like and subscribe to the channel. My name is Ishengoma. Thank you.